Hello, I'm Nikas Klohr, Head of R&D here at ResResult, and in this video I would like to give you a brief overview of what actually happens when we roll out a new firmware update for Ubidium passive antenna mats. So this is a Ubidium passive antenna mat element, and inside this element there's a UHF reader, and part of that UHF reader is a microcontroller which runs a firmware. And that firmware can be upgraded in the field. The question is, how does it get on there? Well, it gets on there over the normal connection cable from an Ubidium decoder. So what typically happens is that you have your Ubidium decoder getting a new update, let's say over your network cable, over internet. So this is your LAN cable. And it stores its own firmware plus the firmware of the reader elements inside its memory. So let's say there is some firmware in there. And this can happen at any point of time. Can happen during a weekday evening when you connect that decoder to your local internet at home. So the next time you bring that decoder to an event and you connect the Ubidium floor mat to it, let's say in this case with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 elements, you plug it in, and the decoder will ask the elements, okay, which firmware are you running on? And it will compare it to the firmware it has in its memory. And if those don't match, it will upgrade the elements. So it will ask itself, okay, why is this worth making a video about it? It's quite simple. Well, it can be a little bit more complex. Let's assume you have a second decoder which has not seen that update yet. So there was no internet connection between your events. And now you take that decoder and connect it to that mat. So draw the same thing again. What will happen now is that actually the firmware in the mat is newer than the firmware than the decoder is expecting. And in that case, the firmware will actually downgrade the firmware. So why I'm explaining this? It means that the decoder will always make sure that the elements in the mat that were connected run on the firmware that the decoder needs. That's important. Actually, the firmware upgrade process is quite quick. It can be done within a minute, and it is indicated by U's in the small boxes representing the elements. So if you see a U, means update, and that U tells you that the update is in progress. Important. Now, there is even a little bit more complexity in this here. Assume that you had these mats running on that firmware, and now you add some more mats to it running a different firmware. And as you can mix and match mats whenever and wherever you want, we actually have to expect to have every single element running a different firmware. And as our firmware actually changes how the elements behave, it is very important that what this mat is doing actually matches to what this mat is doing. So for that reason, whenever you connect the mat and there is different firmwares being reported, they will all be updated to the same version. Okay? And this is to make sure that the firmware in the decoder is always compatible to all the elements out there. Why am I telling you this? Well, if you have two or more decoders in your fleet of decoders, it is quite important to make sure they are running all on the same firmware, to avoid updating your mats every time you mix the elements and the decoders. So please make sure that all your decoders run the same firmware to avoid the situation of always updating your mats back and forth. So one more thing about the firmware update for the mat. We try not to run firmware updates very often. Probably my prediction would be that in the future we will see maybe 2 firmware updates per year, not more. But as we can update it, we can implement learnings from real events out there. And as you probably already know, we collect data from real events. We can improve the performance, and actually we're doing just that right now. So in spring of 2025, there will be a major upgrade for the mats, where all mats will get a new update and the performance will be even improved over what we have already been seeing. Of course, it is our responsibility to make sure that we only ship firmware which has been thoroughly tested, and be assured that once we push a new firmware out to be applied to the elements, that this has been run on many, many test events and has been proven to be reliable. And why am I saying this? Well, it is because the mechanism, the way this works, once you connect your mat, you can't avoid updating it. There is no menu and no question asked, because we need the firmware in the mat to be compatible to our firmware in the decoder, and we can't allow you not to update your mat in that situation. I know this is a sensitive topic, but in this case there is a technical necessity to do it that way. Otherwise, we would have to keep our firmware in the decoder compatible to all old existing element firmwares, and we would have to keep the element firmwares compatible to each other, which would not be possible. So, actually, there's not much to really do for you. Maybe one thing you should try is try to have your different decoders always running on the same firmware, so you don't upgrade all your mats all the time. And please be assured that we do lots of testing before we actually ship a new firmware for the elements. Thanks for watching.